Hi there, Scorpio. Welcome to Young Guys to Roll. This is going to be your money, finance, career, whatever has to do with money and making money and your career and how you make money. And it's a timeless reading. So whenever you are guided to watch this video, that's when you're meant to see it. And for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. So what do we have going on, Scorpio? Okay, this is what do you need to know about your business? Ooh. Are you going to meet someone at your business or your job? Someone that's interested in you? You might have someone interested in you. They might be hiding their feelings. We have the Moon card here. This is Pisces energy. It could also be your energy. This could be representing you, Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer. There might be someone at your work that might be interested in you and might be coming towards you to offer you their love. Because this is like teamwork. This is working together. And these are secrets, hidden emotions. It might also come out on around a full moon or a new moon. Okay, let's see. What can you do to move forward? We have Five of Cups. Ooh, Five of Pentacles. And a Two of Cups. See, it seems like this is all... Well, this could be a partnership, too. This Knight of Cups could be offering you a job or wanting to work with you, wanting to collaborate on something. It also could be someone that just wants to collaborate on a project with you. Take it how it resonates. But we do have... you have to let go of this past and feeling abandoned. Maybe something happened in the past in your job situation, maybe around your work, to go together in a partnership here. It's Two of Cups. Now, this could be a soulmate connection. It doesn't have to be a love connection. It can be. But it also could be that you are partnering up with someone in business that is a soulmate as far as for business, that you work very well together. But this card here, this Five of Pentacles, is like this person's feeling like they really don't have any options. They're depressed. They're feeling left out. But there's the key, and there's the hole for the lock that you can open this door. And in there is all you need. So, think positive and get out of the past because the future looks good. Okay, how can you be more financially successful? Let's see, how can you be more financially successful? See that? Walking away from whatever this is that really upsets you, a loss that you had. Maybe it's a failure of a business or a job, and you just keep on reflecting back on that, which is keeping you from getting this union, this partnership. But there is Ace of Wands, so there's something coming in here. And it's, use your creativity. The Ace of Wands is very creative. And start something new. Start something that lights you on fire, that gets your passions going. That's what it feels like. You got to walk away from this burden. Ten of Wands is also an ending to something. Fives are changes. So things are changing. And this is over. Whatever this is in the past. This is no longer. It could be home. Maybe it's even had something to do with this Knight of Cups. I don't know. It can be different for everyone. But you are walking away from something that is no longer serving you. And if you can walk away from whatever you lost, because we have to experience some loss to appreciate when we win something, you know? Okay, what do you need to improve? It seems like you need to improve your own happiness. You have the Ten of Cups here. You're walking away from these burdens, and you're walking right into this Ten of Cups. A lot of happiness, a lot of wish fulfillment of family life. Maybe you need to focus more on your family or your friendships. Because here we have Three of Cups, happiness. Have some fun. Maybe you're not spending enough time having fun. Also, your spiritual connection. This is also higher learning. This is learning something. Maybe you need to learn something new. It's going to be different for everyone. And this reading can't resonate completely with everyone. So take what does and leave what doesn't. But there is something here that you are getting together with someone. We have the Three here for like working together, and we also have the Three of Cups also having fun together. So how about having some fun? How about going out? How about letting your hair down a little bit? Just having some joy here. There's a lot of happiness here. There's many different opportunities too. I feel like look at these bowls. They're all different colors of the rainbow. There's so many choices. There's so much coming towards you. And it's also spiritual enlightenment. I love this card. This Hierophant is so happy, so enlightened. He has nirvana. You know, look at that. This is the spirit here. And he's on top of the world. These cards are very happy. So where or what do you need to improve? You need to improve your happiness. You need to have some fun. You might be spend too much time focusing on work, focusing on your job, and maybe you're not having any fun. And that's, that's not good, because you need an even balance. Okay, what or whom is the obstacle you need to overcome? Wow. Yeah, I think thinking back on the past, this card is someone's really dwelling on the past too much, dwelling on the burdens. Got to move forward, got to live in the present. And here we have the Ace of Cups, and that's a lot of love, a lot of nurturing. You have two aces here. There's a lot of new beginnings here. You might be afraid of a new beginning. You keep on going back on the past and looking at what happened here. When this is coming in, we have the Ace of Wands, we have the Ace of Cups, and we have the Four of Wands, building a great foundation. Maybe you're afraid to do that. Maybe something just collapsed on you. Maybe you lost your home or you lost your business and you're afraid of that. But this is here so that you can have this again. You can have a lot of happiness. A lot of happiness in these cards. Okay, what's coming in the near future? You're walking away from something. The King of Swords. Ooh. And the Four of Swords. Okay, so you're walking away from something to come to something better. You're leaving something behind in order to achieve this happiness. And hopefully it's all this sadness and all this remorse and this dwelling on the past. But we do have the King of Swords here. Now that could be Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. And this is someone that's very smart. Also with this card, I always feel like very in tune with the nature and the animals. And they might be interested in you. So you might have an air sign that's coming towards you. Maybe they're leaving something behind coming towards you. And they think about you a lot. I mean, there's nice, pleasant dreams here. They might think about you in the morning and at night. This is someone you know. Or it might be someone that is interested in you and you're not even aware of it. Because I don't see any past cards here. It looks like it might be someone brand new, and maybe you're not aware of it. Or maybe once you do meet them, you're going to be thinking about them like this. This is a card, Four of Swords, of taking some time out too. Just having a break, maybe meditating, just chilling a little bit, And on the bottom we have Seven of Pentacles. You're going to work on something here. You're going to nurture to make something grow. This looks really nice. So far, I'm liking everything here. So what or whom is helping you? Let's see. What or whom is helping you? Ooh. Ooh. All right. So we have the Wheel of Fortune here. This is another 10. So this is like something new start, something ending for new, something ending for something new to start. And it's also divine timing. Things are changing in your favor. You're coming into your power. Get the Emperor here. This could be who's helping you, Aries, or a boss, or someone with power. But I also feel like you're coming into your power. That you are also, this is helping you because you're becoming stronger. Things are changing in your favor. And you're standing above the rest. There's Seven of Wands. You are going deep within. You're meditating. You're, because we got this card here. I feel like this is very strong for meditation. And also with this card, she looks like she's meditating or doing some yoga, but really focusing on her spirituality. And also with the Hierophant here, it's a very strong spiritual connection. This is this Aries, like I said, could be a boss, could be someone that's influential, or someone that has some way of helping you. that you can't, they can help you in a ways that you can't help yourself, so they can be helping you. Or this Emperor can also stand for like a business or a company. It doesn't have to be a person. It could be the government. You know, someone with power. And it's going to happen in divine timing, because this is also helping. So this is also the universe is helping you with the Wheel of Fortune. That's the universe coming in. Major Arcana is the universe. It's not what we can do. It's the universe helping. So things are shifting in your favor to help you. Okay, now your potential outcome. What is Scorpio's potential outcome? Ooh, the World. The Empress. The Nine of Swords. Well, you're thinking too much about things, and that's worrying you. But I really like this Nine of Swords, because we have these blackbirds. I don't know if they're ravens or crows. And then you have white spirit bird coming in here to like get rid of these. So divine is helping you in this sense. If you're worried about something, the potential outcome of something, it's going to be okay, because you got the World here. Something could be coming back around. Now with the World card, something that maybe you thought was over could be returning. It also could be, the World means completion. It's also being really happy, like you're having everything you want. But you do have the Empress here. So this is your energy, that you are the Empress, that you're able to create whatever you want. Being very fertile, very nurturing. This is taking care of the planet, taking care of all of those around you, being able to take care of people around you, being able to give birth to something. This could be a new job, a new business. This could be literally a baby. So if you don't want to have a baby at this time, or you don't want to get your person pregnant at this time, take precautions. But this is amazing. I'm really getting, I keep on getting pulled to all these circles. Like we have this circle here for her belly and representing the earth. And then we have the moon. And then we have the circle here for like the hula hoop or whatever she's in here is a circle. We have the Wheel of Fortune here. And even the chair that he's sitting on looks like a big orange, looks like a circle to me. And there's a circle here. There's something about things keep on coming around or being in this loop. Look at this. There's just a lot of circles that are really popping out for me. Even the bowls, they're like circular for the top. And then we have the pentacles here. There's just the lights here, the green, red, and yellow, orange, and then we have the moon again. It's just, there's something that is going to be whole. It's going to be completed. I feel like things are coming around, that things are working to get to that point. They might have to go through different kind of shifts and changes like these figures here, but they're going to end up with this completeness. The World. It really feels very strong that you're going to be completing something. That's going to be very significant. And you might be worried about something, but I think that's going to come to pass. At the bottom, we have the Seven of Pentacles. It's pulling up again. This came out before. You're going to nurture something to make it grow, and it's really going to grow quite substantially. You're really going to enjoy the way they're nurturing, that you're going to get into taking care of whatever this is that you're trying to achieve. This feels really awesome. It just, let go of the past. And if you let go of the past and what didn't go well, you are making room for something to go well, because you can't stay in the past. The past is going to keep you there. You got to stay in the present to create this wonderful future. Okay, let's see what else we have for you guys. I'm really enjoying this reading. I think there's a lot of new beginnings coming out for you guys. There's a lot of things that you are able to create. You're in your power. This is awesome. And my hand is itchy. That means money. Ooh, okay, strength. Leo could represent a Leo. Did I go through any more cards here? Yeah, Aries. Okay, let's see. We have spirit guide. You are getting guided. You are getting information from your guides. And family. Family is very important. Like here, it's spend time with family. But this is like a family card too. And enjoying yourself, having some fun. Your family's supporting you too. You also have the spirit guide. You have your spirit family too. They're all around you. Angels around you. They're family and home. Home on the bottom here. So You might be focusing at home. Maybe you're working from home, or maybe you're working on your home. But home is important. Home is your structure, your stability, and also Four of Wands, that represents home too. So this is an awesome reading. I really like it for you guys. There's a lot. You have the strength to do what you need to do. You don't forget, you're not alone. Even if you feel alone, you always have the spirit world around you that is helping you. They're trying to help you. Even your loved ones that pass over, when they pass over, their job now is to help people here. And they might be giving you little nudges or telling you little things that you need to do. Even coming through in these readings, they might be the ones that are pulling the cards. Besides the angels and guides, it also could be your people that have passed over that are doing this. Family is coming very strong, so they're around you. Feel them, even the people that are present in your life that you are on the third dimension. There's also people on that have passed over to another dimension, so they're around you too. So, and especially with this Hierophant card coming out here, that's very strong too. That communication, that connection, that higher learning. That this is just an awesome reading. I'm so happy for you guys, and I hope you like this reading. And please like, share, and subscribe. And hope to see you again real soon. Thank you.